We're going in for the long haul. So we're packing Sandy's. Get yourself some Jif. This bread is insanely soft. It's almost too soft. We got PB&Js on deck to keep us nice and warm while we're in the blind. That's how she wrote, folks. 4 PB&Js compliments of your boy.
Some don't last the way they should. Some make you feel good for a little while. And then you throw them away. Some are up on a shelf for some other time. Some are high dollar, some ain't worth a dime. But you keep them anyway. Yeah, everybody's looking for something. So how do I catch your right? If your shoes shot, walk a mile with me. Slipping Cinderella, slipping right on your feet.
Well, we're back up here. It's 11:15. Got up here a lot earlier today. Dean and I figured if we're going to boot deer going in, we need to give ourselves the most amount of daylight after that for everything to settle back down and hopefully the deer kind of reconjugate up by that blind. I mean, this place is overwhelming. It really is. That's how many deer are here. And I mean, I get all like anxious and like uptight because you don't want to get in there and you want everything to be perfect. You don't want to spook anything, but you gotta kind of relax and just realize where you're at and the opportunity that we have. And I mean, from a couple kids that grew up hunting in Western New York, this watching this on like monster bucks and, you know, the DVDs as we were young boys, this is what we dreamed about and we're living it right now. So literally have to soak up every moment. And so we're going to go sneak in there. We haven't had anything on the camera in like an hour, which is good. There's deer there all day long. And I act like that's a problem. It's not. It's just we need to get in there, hopefully spook as little amount of deer as possible. Once we're in, we're golden. We're golden. But it's just sneaking in there. That's the tough part. And that is the get you up tight. But we're going to get dressed, locked down in the snow camo, and we're gonna sneak in there. It's literally 2 degrees right now. This is the coldest day we've hunted this week, and it's a little bit breezy. We got some snow flurries coming down. I love it. This is the perfect day condition, late season, that I like. So we're gonna go in there and give them hell.
For sure.
Yeah, for sure. That is definitely a coyote.
Hopefully he died.
It's punched. Hopefully he did die. I've got a feeling
that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. Feeling tonight's the night.
Yeah.
We kill a buck.
Yeah.
We gon' draw bows. We gon' have luck.
Yeah.
I promise you.
Sure.
We sit here long. We're gonna kill one. Then we go home. Yeah.
is pissed, man. I don't know what he's pissed at, but he's pissed.
Looks like a nice deer, tall rack.
It's like that doe's in heat or something. He's right in front of that feed pile.
Oh, he went back up there?
Yeah, dude, he's just not leaving that doe side.
Deer all over this place. It's out of control. I don't know how else to describe it. You can't describe it any other way. It's out of control.
Possibility sitting in that one, but even with a not the greatest wind, like just taking pressure off this one,
I know,
for the last 2 days could be beneficial. But we're seeing the same amount of deer pretty much every night. Our wind was kind of questionable tonight, and it showed these deer were just, they were real skittish coming in here, but it ain't over yet, McGavin. You got 3 days, Bigelow, and we're not going down without a fight, because all the deer are here and they're not leaving this farm. They're not leaving, so we just got to figure out how to get them in bow range. And the last 2 days. The wind's going to be perfect for this spot. We got 3 days left. We're going to figure out what we want to do tomorrow or what we can do. We might not have any options. We got to see. But if not, I think it's going to go down. We just got to be smart. You have to be smart.